So we want to talk about film finance. We try to give away as much information as possible on all the various sources of finance and how you piece them possibly together to produce. I mean, we always use feature films as an example, of course, which is by far the most complicated, work to be done for a producer, especially in Europe, where you can't finance a picture out of just one source, but you need, I don't know, dozens of sources that have to be pieced together. That's the one side of it, of course. What I also want to stress is how to talk and communicate to the financiers. A lot of producers believe when they come with their project that the world has to react to their demands and to their wishes and to their dreams and their visions. But producers also have to understand that behind every financier there is a very distinct interest. Now, when we talk about financiers, who are they? Right. So when you talk to a public funder, when you talk to a regional fund person, when you talk to someone in a national film board, etc., these people have a totally different interest in the film and what their job and involvement and financial involvement in that film is than, say, a banker or someone who comes in for sheer commercial interests, i.e. What we call the equity investors. And again, when you talk to a distributor, they all look at your project in a different way, and you need to understand what these people can do for you, but you also have to understand what you have to do to make their business work. So it's a communication that has to go both ways. And certainly the worst mistake it is that you say, I have a project and you have to give me money. Right? Nobody has to do anything. Right? You have to create a partnership, you have to create a business that is of mutual interest. And only then you can start talking about your project. You can only talk to financiers when you understand their business. You cannot go to a distributor and not having the data in your head. If you don't know what their market is, if you don't know which films they have out in the cinemas, if you don't know what the environment of distribution and theatrical distribution and video distribution is. And when I go to a broadcaster and I talk to a commissioning editor, I need to know what ZDF, what RTL, what, French television and the BBC are doing. I have to understand their business model. I have to understand what kind of audience target they have. And I have to know whether my film would fit into their needs or not, i.e. I have to understand whether there's a demand for what I'm doing. Right? So not having them only understand what I want to do, but the producer has to understand whether his product would ever be of any interest for those people. Right? How do I start this? Financiers love dry information, to just come into a conversation. What is dry information? It's always a good idea to have a business plan with you. And I don't have to explain what kind of information a business plan, a fully fledged business plan, and I'm talking about a company business plan, should comprise of. But it is, of course, very precise information, right, on who the people are, what the management is, what the vision of that management is, where the company comes from, like dry data as it was registered then and then, it has its offices there and there, it's capitalized to that and that and that amount, and all the legal information, all the financial information, a good description on where you believe as a producer, as a production company, where you believe you stand, right? So you have to have a look at competition. You have to have a look at who are the people I want to work with, what kind of films I want to make, what kind of markets I want to approach. All these informations are very, very important, right? A lot of producers believe that, I don't know, a business plan is a piece of crap that nobody would read. Wrong. If I'm really interested in you, then I will read the business plan. And if you don't even come with a business plan, I do not want to talk to you in the first place. Right? So that is a vital, vital piece of information. And it is indeed fascinating if you read good business plans. If it's just a crappy piece of paper, right, that they say, okay, I mean, these guys spent like a day on it and assembled the basic information, etc. That's my first impression. You don't care. Right? You do not invest work to impress me. right? And I want to be impressed because you are not the only one. There are hundreds of people who may come towards me and ask for my money, right? So I want to stand out. I want to be the best. And a piece of a business plan, right, that is really a sexy piece, and I use that word, right? It can be made sexy. It can show, you know, that you care about your business, your company, your management, the people you employ, etc., etc. Helps a lot, helps a great deal to come in so that I respond and say, hey, interesting guys, let's talk, right? So that's one of the first ones. The second one is, of course, also very, very often underestimated, right? The importance of compiling all the information on your project. I call that the project business plan. That's a second business plan. That's a separate business plan. And that not only serves to impress me, right, that you have a great script and that you want to do a big film, but that, again, you show that you understand the business, that you know exactly, that you have given thought, you know, of, I want to produce this film. It will reach an audience in this and this segment, be it age, be it social, be it what, in these and these countries, that you understand what genres are. So many people say, well, you know, this is a family film, right? It's a film that kids can see and also they can go to the cinema with their grandmothers. Family films? Disney does family films. I don't know a lot of family films in Europe, right? So you say, okay, no, it's a picture like this one and this one and this one, and that's the importance of positioning your film, of knowing about other films that your film can be compared to, and of course automatically you say, and this film has made so many admissions and it was out on prime time and that broadcast on that slot and it reached, I don't know, 8.7 million people, etc., etc. Combine your vision with data. Right? It may sound stupid, you know, but if you get it right, right, you will impress finance and you will attract finance because then you are seen as a business partner and not as a mere producer who has great ideas but doesn't understand that my money means business and not the, I don't know, support of a cultural work. That is simply not enough. What else is important? Information. Information is of the essence. Good information, steady information. You do not only talk to your banks or to your distributor who you want to have on board or the public support people, etc. When you have good news, you also talk to them when you have bad news, right? So they're not really surprised, you know, when you come over and said, and by the way, 6 weeks ago, this and this happened. You know, you let them know when it happens, okay? This steady flow of information, this good communication, and I'm not talking about, I don't know, shooting around with, hey, we're doing this and that. I'm really talking about communication, is of vital importance, right? That's building trust, that's building confidence, right? And of course, you can filter information, right? I mean, you give them bits and pieces, early information. Don't overload it, right? When you're in early stages of development of a project, don't talk to them about can, right? Talk about what's important now, okay? And as I say, steady. Of course, you can say, here is business information, here is buzz information, right? But don't mix the two, right? Don't talk about financial information or legal information and mix it up with, and by the way, we also want to reach the red carpet in, I don't know, Los Angeles, etc., etc. Be professional how you communicate with financiers. Right, and always bear in mind that you're not the only one. Clean information. Clean information means that that you don't hide information. Right? I mean, tell people, you know, where you come from, and don't hide anything because it will come out, so to speak, anyway. Right? So be very clear what it is. And again, you know or have someone who knows. Right? How to structure information so that we say, okay, this is my legal documentation, this is my financial information, this is how we assess risk, this is our point and how we do controlling, right? Controlling is very, very important, right? Come in and talk to a banker and say, we have a person who knows about financial controlling, and they will be impressed. Encourage people to risk assess themselves in a way. Am I really good enough for what I'm doing? Am I really good enough to sell, so to say, my film? Or do I need other partners, right, who know maybe more, i.e. the point I want to make, where you discover weaknesses in yourself, in your collaborators, in the person next to you, in your office, etc., etc., balance it out and say, we know that we are only doing our third film, right? We've never done a picture that was bigger than 3 million. Now we talk to you about a 10 million picture, but look who we have as a co-producer, as an executive producer, as a law firm, as a financial consultant, etc. Balance out weaknesses with strength and you will impress the financier because he sees that you care. Full stop.